Yeah, you know, I'm sorry about the fact that you couldn't drive in. You know, in Nigeria, you must pay your tax. But even after paying your tax, you'll still be your own water corporation. You'll be your own PACN. You are your own Minister of Works because, so obviously, this road is being tarred now and it's 100% pertinence. It's not the local government. We are the one tying the road. So we are trying to fix it so that, because it started raining and this year it became very messy. And we just felt, let's solve this problem once and for all. And even the parking lot we have there, people could not, you know, customers will come, they'll park their cars and it wasn't good enough. So that's why we felt, okay, let's fix the car park, fix the road. Then we are trying to put more like a playing ground there because it should not be all walk. People should be able to play. So there'll be a mini football pitch there, lawn tennis court, basketball, you know, not necessarily big, but there's something small that our staffs, our stakeholders can also play and just relax, what's it called, during work. But for this structure, we are putting it up because we decided to diversify the business. One major area of interest to us is banking. By the second year of the business, we started thrift collection. That's another thing I've not mentioned. Ajo. Okay. That was a business. The business has been since then. So we recruited young people. They go from, you know, the way they collect Ajo, we keep it for people, pay them back. And the business has been since then up until now. But last year, we decided to go the technology way, doing the same business. And what prompted it? About 4 years ago, I have in my note, I think October 2014 or 2015, I have in my note there where I noted that this thrift contribution we're doing, that we should go the technology way then. But we spoke with some friends that are into IT, but maybe they didn't get what we're trying to say. And because we could not afford to hire people to do it then, we felt these guys are close to us. If they can solve this problem, we promised them some stake in it. But they didn't get it. That was how we abandoned it. Only for like a few years ago, we employed a staff here. And he saw that we're doing this. And he told us, can't we introduce technology to this thing? We didn't take him seriously. You know, there is a way that your mind might not be looking at him. Suddenly, we just saw that he came to us and said, see, what he told us, he told some of his friends about it, and they have started and they are doing big within a short time. They are like the biggest guys when it comes to, and that's Piggy Vest. Yeah. The guy that told them about the idea works, he's still with us. He's not the head of our own, but good enough, they are still friends, they still share because they every time Piggy Vest go to do presentation, the young man they normally talk about that said he saved money in Kolo, Piggy Bank, for years and made mention of it on Twitter. And they called him, how did you do it? And he started making colo for every one of them. And at a point, they decide, they talk about it every time you ask them about how they started. The young man is with us today. So, and they are still friends. He's the one now editing our own version of what Piggyverse do. So, last year we decided to go, we acquired our microfinance license from banking, but we told ourselves we want to focus on technology. So we decided to start with PertiSave, which is actually a group of companies. So Pertinence Properties Limited is like the construction arm of our business. And we have some projects we've done, not just for Pertinence. For example, when they were building Kenan City at Kenan Land, we got a contract to build some of them. We have had to build one or two roads for people. We are doing one here that you can see. PPL also built this structure. Yeah, you know, Shegun was with PPL then. It was the one heading that arm of the business before he resigned in December. So all of these businesses, they need a space. So that's why we are putting this up to accommodate. That's the whole essence of the structure and ensuring it will fix the environment. All right, thank you very much. We should be coming out with a book very soon, and I know that book will sell because I've had to answer this question. Oh God. I would say that's the most asked question that I've had to answer, and it's simply because in this part of the world, people just believe partnership don't just work. they just believe that somewhere along the line there will always be a problem. Especially now that you're having Igbo man and Yoruba man coming together and they're making it work. Okay, I'll just share with you briefly. Firstly, we're covenant people, no doubt about it. But that's not just it, but that's the foundation. I want to start from that. We can't take that out, the fact that we're covenant people, we're covenant friends. So before business, there was friendship. Even though people have advised that don't go into business with your friend. So for us, before business, there was friendship. But when friendship was going to turn to business, we defined it clearly. The best time to share money is when there is no money. So we came together, invited a lawyer to draft a partnership deed for us. So when there was no money, we shared all the money that we were going to be making. So we all, you knew your stake, I knew my stake. You knew what to expect, I knew what to expect. Are you pleased with it? So with that, we started. But along the line, it takes a lot of tolerance also. It's just like marriages. If you can run your marriage successfully and you take partnership from the marriage perspective like we have done, I think it makes it work too. We took it from that angle, more like whatever we are doing, the ultimate goal. We have arguments, but interestingly, when we argue, it is because of the ultimate, not for my advantage, not for his advantage. We have never had any issues since this partnership started. Yeah, nobody has ever come to say, Sunday, what happened? Wisdom. He has never reported me to anyone. I've never reported him to anyone. We have never, as in nothing, as not the slightest one. And people keep wondering, how are you guys making it happen? Like I said, it takes a lot of tolerance, it takes a lot of patience. But another thing that I think works for us is the fact that even though it's a partnership, each of us, we work as though it's an individual business. How do I mean? My commitment to this business is 100%. Normally in a partnership, it should be 50-50. I put 50%, you put 50%. And I think I can vouch that his commitment is also 100%. We do not try to make one person look superior than the other in terms of flaunting what you have that the other person does not have. No. We don't do that. We ensure that togetherness, what is of most important to us is the goal that we want to achieve, imparting people. And there is a level you get to in life that if you are not greedy, that's why I look at our politicians at times, I wonder what are they looking for. For example, at this level in my life now, there's nothing I need that I cannot afford. So what's the point trying to, I don't know, both of us, we've gotten to the level where there's nothing, I'm talking about basic necessities of life. There's no car I want to drive today, I cannot drive. There's no part of the world I want to travel to, I can't travel to. I'm not even thinking of myself any longer now. All I think of is about people. How many lives can I impact? Those cars I believe I can buy, how many people can I buy it for? How many people can I build those houses for? How many people can I send to school? That's even what I'm thinking of now because I see my own case as already settled. So I should focus on people now. So I think greed is out of it. Of course, every man has an element of greed, but when it's so insignificant, it makes partnership work. So for both of us, somehow we have been able to manage that when you are content with what you have. This contentment has come before now. It didn't come when things started happening financially. It came, we had it before things started coming. So I feel that has also helped. Wow, that's interesting. Yeah, January 2019, I started fully building the brand Olorunsheyi. If you had followed me before now, you see everything I've been doing has been pertinence. But since this year began, I started building the brand Olorunsheyi and just make it a brand that stands on its own outside of pertinence because I knew the things I want to do in the next 5-10 years. The focus, I have three areas of focus: leadership, business, and governance. And when I talk about governance, people quickly ask me, you want to contest? And I said, no. Not necessarily. There's difference between governance and politics. The things the courses I did at my master's level were deliberate, they were strategic. I took master's in business administration because I knew business is one of the three, the tripod. It's on a tripod like we have here, business. I took a master's in public administration because I knew governance is what. And the third master's I'm pursuing is in global management, and it's because leadership is the third stand upon. And people wonder, why three masters? When I speak in each of these, I want to speak as an authority. I don't want people to say, I don't want those in the academies to say, you can't address us, what do you know about this? Don't think because you have grown the business, you can come and bamboozle us. I want to know what the way they think, and I already know how entrepreneurs think. I want to know the way they also think. So for me, those three areas, I want to see how I can build my brand to add value in these three areas. So that's why I started organizing events. In the month of March, I had my first event that is centered on leadership, because the leadership has its children, and one of it is the Olorunsheyi mentoring platform that we started. Amazingly, the rate at which people registered, because I've learned not to do things for free. People don't appreciate it. So we started the Olorunsheyi mentoring platform, and we have more than the number that we even need, that we admitted this year. So in the month of March, I released a book on mentoring. Yeah, leverage. We held a major event, and we had people come from everywhere to be a part of this. So this is in line of the leadership that I talked about that we're growing. The mentoring platform has been amazing. We just in 6 months, less than 6 months, so much value, testimonies are already coming from everywhere. So that takes care of that. For the business, of course, people already know me as a businessman and that I'm doing and I'm enjoying it. But there are new frontiers in business that I'm really looking forward to attaining. Then the governance, I've been a bit silent on it, but I'm going to start with event. I'm a product of apps, helped by people, helped by God. I felt, okay, if God has helped me, I need to help others. So we started the Olorunsheyi Foundation this year. And I was just checking the records. I discovered that in less than 7 months, we have done over 3 million naira in grants to people for business. For education grants, we have done over 1 million naira. And just before my birthday, we still have so much to do, just to the little that God has blessed us with. Let's see how we can share with other people. So talking about the next 5-10 years, it's about repositioning the brand Sunday Olorunsheyi and see how I can add more value to the world.